Right, hey guys, welcome to another stream. This is going to be another Australian full GP with 58 laps. I hope you enjoy it. I'm going to start off by doing a one attempt qualification and see how far I get up that, and then work my way into the race and through, and hopefully try and win. The difficulty is set quite high, so I don't know how well I'm going to do or how badly. I think I'm going to try and start with the medium spec tyre in hopes I can go longer on my first stint during the race. I don't know if it's a good idea because I could be quite far back on the qualification, but there's only one way to find out. So I'm going to go for the medium tyre, and I'm also going to go on maximum top speed. Because, well, you need it on this race. That way, you definitely need it on this race to get the speed down the straights to be able to overtake people. Otherwise, it can be quite a difficult place to overtake. So, with any ado, let's go to the track. Okay, I'm on the correct tyre, so that's good. It's a good start. You want to try and turn in as early as possible there. So you can get on the power a lot earlier. We'll use the accelerator just to help turn the vehicle at the top of the hill. Ease on the power. The slingshot you down here. Is that enough? Is it enough? Is it enough? Come on, qualification number one. Oh, second, motherfucker. Who got me? I bet you Leclerc has got P1. He just seems so much on it on this game. So,
with qualifying finished,
I think he might
be
there.
It's time to remind ourselves of our top three. Verstappen, Hamilton, and Valtteri Bottas.
Wow. With qualifying wrapped up, we now have our grid line up for the big race tomorrow. 5,000
of a second. Be sure to join us then for what will
no doubt be a fantastic race. Which could mean the difficulty is too easy. But there's only one way to find out. We need to get into the race. It's going to be quite a long race, so... see what we can do. Let's get on it. Let's get on it. Let's get on it. So what are you guys thinking of 2020 Formula One? Seems quite interesting. I'm looking forward for the potential of the German Grand Prix returning. Because that will definitely be nice. That's the Nordschleife Formula One track.
Welcome to Spielberg for another exciting Formula One race. This circuit is renowned for its backdrop, surrounded by natural beauty. Well, it certainly is an idyllic destination for the Austrian Grand Prix.
The Red Bull Ring. I don't really understand why they cartooned that. You know, I drew it on. They could have used real pictures.
One of the shortest laps of the season. One time around here is a distance of 2.6 miles, with the best overtaking chances into turn one or the tight uphill turn three. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, You're no stranger to surviving the melee of turn one. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
Well, the throttle goes both ways, Crofty. You've got to have the discipline not to try and win the race on the first lap. So always be prepared to lift early and give those around you more space. Trying to be the last of the late
might
breakers with
actually
half a dozen cars around you may pay off from time to time.
Have a cigarette before we actually start.
With the race minutes away from starting,
it's going to be a long race.
Grid rundown looks like young superstar Max Verstappen starts from pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Leclerc, Sebastian Vettel, and Albon, Ricciardo, Ocon, Kvyat, and Sergio Perez, Stroll, Sainz, Kimi Raikkonen, and Norris, Gasly, Giovinazzi, Kevin Magnussen, and Nicholas Latifi. Grosjean and George Russell ends our grid lineup. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
Where the hell did I put that to? Must be in the kitchen. I have no idea, where the hell did I put that? Right, ladies and gentlemen. No. That's a lot of stops. And it's strategy. I wonder if we can go for the hard. And make it last. Remove stint. It says add 13 seconds. If we add a stint right at the end. Then you might as well for stint to go on the medium tyre. Nah. Remove stint. I know what I'm doing. I know better, obviously. 74 laps, it's a... Why so much fuel? How long is it? Is it 71 laps, is it? Could have sworn the Austrian Grand Prix. You fucking twat. 71 laps. No. Activity log. Dum dum. Edit. Right. Stream. Well, noob. I should have known it was over. Being such a short lap. Accidentally pressed the wrong one for the information. Okay. Let's go on it. Let's do the race. At this point, I didn't actually check to see what I actually said it at. I said it at 70. I don't mind doing some fuel saving, so. Get that fucking temperature up. There we go. Right. We're from the grid. Why do they always do this? Bottas is on second, don't worry. Just letting the last of them line up. Have any contact? No. Clean. It's close, but it's clean. So I'm gonna get swarmed on the first lap. That's the problem with having just a soft tire on. It does take a little time to get up to temperature. The take button a little bit, I think. Especially on the exits of corners. Ooh. A bit of out of section. A bit of out of balance there. That's a shit first corner. See, the overtake button really helps you when you start bogging. Stay with Max there. He will just up and fuck off otherwise. Nearly 2 seconds away from me. Down to 1.3. That's why when I got on the straight, I'll have to pause it to see if I've everything switched on correctly. Oh, was a terrible couple of laps anyway. Gameplay settings. Safety car's on. Vehicle damage full. Nice. Carry on then. My fault, he's got so far away. I should do a couple of laps and lean, get that fuel down. Push a bit later on then. So much grip compared to me on them soft compounds. Hopefully, when they start to wear, I will come back at him. At the minus 22 on fuel. Something about this track though. I'm so glad that they managed to race here this year. During the 2020 F1 at Austria, and the Styrian Grand Prix. It's absolutely fine, any of that would happen going on the soft compound, low fuel. No problem, is I'm slightly backing up into the Ferraris at the moment. Shit. Yeah, really backing up into the Ferraris doing that. That definitely won't help me out. I'd love to know what these actual top speed of these cars would be if they had a long enough straight. And put like as little downforce as possible. Be interesting. Way into the 200s. Probably too fat, I would have thought. 1,000 horsepower, anyway, 700 kilos ish. Maybe a little bit more. picked up staying around 2.8. How much fuel have I got? I got 6. So the cars behind me are definitely catching up. Strapping, or the strap on, I say. Right. Let's try honing on the strapping a little bit more. Tires definitely going off. I really thought I'd put this on the on a quite hard difficulty, but seem to be doing okay on my own. That's not gonna help my time. That was disappointing. Might just try to get in his. Might try to get in his DRS and then. Turn the engine out a little bit more. because I feel like I might need it a bit later on in the race. Obviously. Under 2 seconds. One 7. One 6. The problem is when you get a little bit too close. You do definitely get the air deflection off the car in front. Slightly messes up your error. Second, there we go. Fucked it with that then. Way too early there. Not early enough there. Shit, I'm out of DRS. What's wrong with my tyres? Still plenty of grip in there. Looks like my tyres are going off a little bit, but look alright on the sheet. Gotta do at least another 12 laps on this tyre. Bit of oversteer there. Managed to correct it, so that's okay. Didn't lose too much time. My God. Damn it, all spent. Too much of a spin. Feel it closer. It's in DRS. Start a few laps again, then don't worry about that.
boy. Bastard.
touch her eyes for a while. Definitely going to be in front of me. For strap on. Ooh. more sound in my head. Lap 35 on the straight, I will be having a eye break because it hurts. Turn our TV this close for this long. It's incredibly painful. I think I've got the brightness of the screen up too high. I need to work on my racing lines a bit. Like where to turn in and that. That was fucking dog shit, see? Manage your mum. Okay, these guys are dog shit. No, my car's only 3 seconds behind. Scheiße. I find on this corner, you need to turn exactly where the last post is. So. Just can't get my point quite right on that one. Sometimes it seems to grip up really well, other times it doesn't. Some DRS would be nice. Surely I'm within a second of that bloke. Right, so guys, on the straight I'll be taking a few minute break just to adjust my eyes. Hope you're okay with that. was gaining about 1/10 of that. Oh, fuck that up. Okay, guys, let's finish this race. Oh, the grass. Alright, this happens 4 seconds now. This way wasn't that far, but more. See if we can change that. Purple middle sector. Got Verstappen in front of us. I know they need to last, don't you worry about that. But I think Verstappen's gonna pit again. I think he went in front of a soft set of tyres. Whereas I'm going to try and go to the end. Right, 3.2 seconds to Verstappen. Let's do it. We're going to catch him 2.8 seconds to Verstappen. Oh, blue flag's ahead, so it could be Verstappen. Has he let Kevin Magnussen through? I think that's Kevin Magnussen ahead. Two point six seconds. Finally got the fastest lap. That's Giovinazzi. Giovinazzi, get out of my way. I'll use your tape, thank you. As for Verstappen, 1.6 seconds. Just gotta get ahead of Latifi now. Come on. Thank you. Come on, someone hold him up. One point three one eight. Come on. Oh, shit. Fuck off, I didn't get DRS. Shit, I was back on it. Get so much wheel spin on that. That corner. What's the matter for strapping? Struggling on those tires. This would be the best strategy. Then I got 30 laps to go on these tires. So maybe I should have gotten another couple of laps on the other stint. Fuck off, I was out. Half times I've lost it there going on then. Way too late, that was my fault. Funny thing is, I do think now I've got enough in the bag to be able to overtake him. Oh, he's going for a pit. He's doing it. Oh. So I pit right at the end for... I could always pit for some super softs. No, these are the mediums now, aren't they? No, they're hard to me. currently on the fastest lap, so... No, I just got the car full of tires and I should be okay. It's not a threat, is he? This face so far behind. Why have they made Ferrari so good in this game when they're actually dog shit? That actually goes far. I'd actually go as far as saying that McLaren do have a better car than this year. And with that Mercedes power plant going next year, well, I reckon they'll be number two, potentially. Alongside with half of Red Bull. Just face it. Verstappen's in his own league in that team. Not been touched. Not even close to being touched by Albon. Which is a bit of a shame, because I'm sure Albon was pretty good. I just feel like he rushes too much. He tries too hard to get a job he's got easily in hand done. Just fucks it up every time. I mean, he's a fast driver, he just can't put it together. Which is such a shame. I'd like to see him do well. Then again, Gasly's doing brilliantly. I mean, he's probably outdoing Albon. And he's in a worse car, theoretically. For what I think it is, I think Max Verstappen's just so much taken over that team. Pretty much decided how the car needs to be set up and it only suits his driving style. That's what it seems like. Because, I mean, Verstappen has a very orthodox driving style. That's why he's so quick. Did I say orthodox? I mean, I'm not orthodox. I'm not, actually. Let's just leave the overtake button on for a little bit. Yeah, like when Albon has now collided with Lewis Hamilton twice. Once at the end of last year in Brazil, I think it was, and then he also clouded in here on the first race of this year. I actually got a pit stop in hand now. No, it would still be second. Let's see if we can change that. As soon as I see it toggling, I might actually pit. It's got a lot of traffic to go through soon now, so I might actually slow him down a bit. Anybody been watching the F2 this year? Mick Schumacher seems to be doing a bit better now. Seems to have got more comfortable with the speed of the car. I do believe it's still too early for him to come into Formula 1. Although I'm not actually sure how old he is, but he looks like a spotty teenager, so... It would have been better, I think, if he hid his true identity for a bit longer. Called himself something different. And then when he reached Formula 1 to have the good surprise. Yes, I'm Mick Schumacher. Mind you, I think there's too many people in F1 that have probably let it slip. The news journalists. Ted Clavitz. Oh, I'm in first now. If I have a pit. Must have finally got to them, finally got to the, back markers. That's a good, brilliant, no, I mean, not even an impression. This house would easily do another 20 laps. Levels are impressive with these tyres, I must admit. I wish the computer knew. Thought this was the fastest strategy. Seconds now for Verstappen. Albon in 6th, about to be lapped. I expect he might actually be lapped by his... That was lucky. That's how you'd overtake the backmarkers. Maybe I should try this track on the 100. No dog I found lap record, that is the question. can't believe that even with that softer tire they weren't able. Using a controller, you should do this with your arms every now and then. Brilliant. You can feel the vibrations from your controller. It almost feels more realistic that you're going over the bumps. Just try it. I didn't know what they were worried about. Don't make your tires last to the end, they said. Might as well. Oh shit, did I have overtake on? that was interesting. I made 6 seconds on it. I'm gonna make a few more now. Safety car. gonna be the last lap, guys. So that original gap which I had paying, I got back. What do you mean, driver of the day, Lando Norris? I mean, yeah, he's an amazing driver. Didn't.
A fantastic team effort to secure victory here in the Styrian Alps. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it.
Bottas actually got third. Nice. Yes. There's always one dick who wants to put it on your top. Why have they made him so fucking ugly though in this game? Unbelievable. Pack leader.
Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would
so
you pick 1:05:20.
Well, how fast is that compared to the real
world champion
time?
May be the boring choice at this point, but you can't argue that he's a driver deserving of his reputation.
Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
Have a look. Okay, it was actually Carlos Sainz in the McLaren who done a 1:05:619, which I managed to beat by a little bit. That was on lap 68. What about the Austrian Grand Prix, the first one. It was Lando Norris with a 1:07 on lap 71. So somehow they managed to make 2 seconds. Yeah, 2 seconds. Maybe, well, weather conditions, but most likely. But wow. I'm pretty pleased with that. A 1:05:52. I'm actually interested to see the leaderboards on this. To see what's the fastest anyone's been around here. Thinking about it, it's got to be a 1:03, knowing the people who play this game. Maybe even a 1:02. because, well, Max Verstappen actually got a 1-4 during qualification. 8 laps. But on the Styrian. Time trials, 2020, obviously. Austrian Grand Prix. The lap record has been smashed. So a few leaderboards in the dry. What the fuck? See, is this PC as well? Because there's no way you're getting that with an Xbox controller. I don't care that it was a custom setup. There's no way taking that kind of time. It's got to be faked. Which is quite annoying. I mean, something like a 152, I would believe. Because, I mean, that's fucking quick. Yeah. Okay. Well, that's it for me. I appreciate watching. Thanks for the support. And please subscribe, like or dislike. It's up to you. Sure. It's just here for your viewing pleasure. I like the word pleasure. It gives me pleasure about talking about pleasure. There's so many types of pleasure you can have. I'm probably about to go have another one. Have a good one.